Write the equation of the hyperbola in standard form. Analyzing the equation, notice the y squared term is positive and the x squared term is negative, which means in standard form, we'll write the equation in the second form shown here on the right, where we have the y part minus the x part equals 1. To begin, let's gather the y squared and y terms together, as well as the x squared and x terms. And let's also move the constant to the right side of the equation. The given equation is equivalent to 4y squared plus 32y minus 9x squared minus 54x, and then adding 53 to both sides, we have equals 53. For the next step, we'll factor out the greatest common factor from the y part and the x part. More specifically, we'll factor 4 from 4y squared plus 32y, and we'll factor negative 9 from minus 9x squared minus 54x. Factoring 4 from 4y squared plus 32y, we have 4 times the quantity y squared plus 8y. Notice if we distribute, we still have 4y squared plus 32y. In the next step, we'll complete the square on y squared plus 8y, which means we'll have to add a constant inside the parentheses. Let's leave room for the constant, so we have plus some constant, which we'll determine in the next step. And then factoring negative 9 from negative 9x squared minus 54x, we have minus 9 times the quantity x squared plus 6x. And then again, we'll complete the square on x squared plus 6x, so let's leave room for our constant, equals 53. Let's go back and double check to make sure negative 9 times the quantity x squared plus 6x does give us minus 9x squared minus 54x. Negative 9 times x squared does give us minus 9x squared, and then negative 9 times positive 6x does give us minus 54x. And now we'll complete the square on y squared plus 8y. Recall, to do this, we need to add the square of half of the coefficient of y, or the square of 8 divided by 2, which equals 4 squared, which equals 16. So now we add 16 inside the parentheses, but now we just change the equation. By adding 16 here, notice if we distribute, we really added 4 times 16, which is 64. And therefore, to maintain equality, we now need to add 64 to the right side of the equation. And now let's complete the square on x squared plus 6x. To complete the square, we need to add the square of half of 6 and the square of 6 divided by 2 is equal to the square of 3, which is equal to 9. So now we add 9 inside the parentheses. But again, by adding 9 inside the parentheses, we didn't just add 9 to the left side. We actually subtracted 9 times 9, or 81. Notice if we distribute negative 9, negative 9 times 9 is negative 81, and therefore to maintain equality, we now need to subtract 81 from the right side. For the next step, we will factor the trinomials inside the parentheses. Both will be perfect square trinomials, but let's go ahead and factor them like we normally do. To factor y squared plus 8y plus 16, we would have two binomial factors. The first positions would be y and y, because the first term is y squared. Next, we determine the factors of 16 and add to 8, which are 4 and 4, which give us two factors of y plus 4. And now we'll do the same for x squared plus 6x plus 9. We will have two binomial factors. The factors of x squared are x and x. The factors of 9 that add to 6 are positive 3 and positive 3, giving us two factors of x plus 3. Which means we can now write the equation as 4 times the square of y plus 4 minus 9 times the square of x plus 3 equals, on the right side, 54 plus 64 is equal to 117. 117 minus 81 is equal to 36. And now from here we know when we have the equation in standard form, we need the right side to be equal to 1, which indicates for the next step we'll divide both sides of the equation by 36. More specifically, on the left, we'll divide each product by 36. And now we simplify. Because 36 is equal to 4 times 9, notice 4 divided by 4 simplifies to 1. Similarly, for the next quotient, again, 36 is equal to 4 times 9. And for this quotient, 9 divided by 9 simplifies to 1. And of course, the right side simplifies to 1 as well, which gives us the equation in standard form as the square of y plus 4 divided by 9 minus the square of x plus 3 divided by 4 equals 1. This is the equation of the hyperbola in standard form. And now we're asked to determine the values of h, k, a, and b. Recall, because we have the y squared part minus the x squared part equals 1, the hyperbola has a vertical transverse axis, which indicates the hyperbola opens up and down. Referring back to our notes, let's first determine h and k. Recall, the center of the hyperbola is the point h, k. We always determine h from the x part of the equation, and we always determine k from the y part. We need to be careful here. Notice we have x plus 3, and to determine the value of h, the x part needs to be in the form of x minus h. So if we have x plus 3, this indicates that h is negative 3. And this is because the quantity x plus 3 is equivalent to x minus negative 3. If we simplify x minus negative 3, we do get x plus 3. Similarly, because we have y plus 4, k is negative 4. And now to determine the values of a and b, because a squared is a denominator of the y part, we know a squared is equal to 9, and therefore a equals 3. And the denominator of the x part is b squared. Since b squared is equal to 4, we know b equals 2. Again, we know a is equal to 3 because 3 squared equals 9. And we know b is 2 because 2 squared equals 4. I hope you found this helpful.